Yo, 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 what's up, guys? I'm back again. SciFiTology.com. I just decided to let y'all guys know about a couple things that's going on, like in the group. We had, who was it? Was it Ray? I don't know if it was Ray. Or was it Randy? Oh, Randy Brown asked a question about in Pokemon XYZ. It's the episode where Team Rocket was kidnapping Pikachu. Pikachu wasn't around. Ash was, power level was weaker. And they decided not to kidnap Pikachu because the Thunder Shocks were so weak or whatever. Ash has a special bond with his Pokemon that nobody else has, that it's almost like they get a power boost just from him being their trainer. He just has that brings the extra oomph out of his Pokemon. So you see it with Greninja with the bond ability, you see it with Pikachu with being able to even be, Pikachu shouldn't be that strong being at, you know what I'm saying, non-evolution level, just being like stage one or whatever. We got a lot of funny memes posted up, just crazy stuff. You had the thing with Alicia Silverstone, not understanding why people like Wonder Woman. Because you sucked this back, girl. You're mad that people liked Wonder Woman. If this was somebody like Sigourney Weaver saying this, maybe we'll hold more weight. But yeah, at least still, so you haven't been relevant in a long, long time. Then we have the argument about Dr. Manhattan versus Thanos. It started off asking who will win this battle. I think it was it was Superman, Goku, Doomsday, One Punch Man, Dr. Manhattan, and Thanos. And off bat, I'm like, yeah, it's no way this doesn't just skip the BS. It's between Dr. Manhattan and Thanos. They both have very, very similar powers, which a lot of people, I think they don't know. I believe Thanos will win. If y'all think Dr. Manhattan will win, y'all could go down there, tell me why, put the points out. Give me both sides, though. Why you don't think Thanos is strong enough, why you think Dr. Manhattan's not strong. You know, either way, don't just argue one side, give me both. Let me see if I can list their powers. They both have very similar powers, man. That's what's crazy. Real similar powers. That's what's really crazy about this, yo. You gotta love technology. I just pulled this shit up. Dr. Manhattan powers. I normally write this stuff down, but why? When you got internet. But y'all should try to join us on the Facebook group, man. We get into all types of nerdy stuff, nerdy conversations like this. It's crazy. Let's see. We all know that he got his powers from the nuclear physics experiment. He has superhuman strength, telekinesis. He could teleport himself over planetary and planetary distances. He control matter on subatomic levels. And it's something else he does. What the fuck else does he do? Does anybody know what the fuck a symbol on his head means? I always wondered that. If you know, tell me. I never knew what the symbol on Dr. Manhattan's head meant. Oh, his clairvoyance. He has like a near total level clairvoyance. It's like crazy. He perceives the past, present, and future like it's all happening at one time. So like he doesn't really have a concept of time. Like he has a concept of time, but like it's all happening simultaneously. So like he's living out his entire life at, you know what I'm saying, all at the same time. But he perceives he believes that he cannot act on that knowledge since his own actions and reactions to chronological events are predetermined. So even though he knows everything that's going to happen, everything that would happen, everything that did happen, he doesn't change anything because he feels like it's all predetermined and it should happen anyway. So I wonder if that would change if, like, he was in, like, a crazy battle with Thanos and had to change that up. You know what I'm saying? Like, if he would change the way he was, he did the thing. Because I do believe it's something that I know somebody's going to tip out. He does have, he did influence the rebirth by taking, like, taking a piece, he got rid of New 52 by taking a piece of time, like, making a part of time disappear. But I do believe Thanos, without the, with the Infinity Gauntlet, even without it, he can exist outside time. So, I want to pull up, it's really hard to find, I want to pull up Thanos' powers without the gauntlet, just to show what kind of powers he has without the gauntlet. Alright, Thanos is a mutant member of a race of superhumans known as the Titanian Eternals. The character possesses abilities common to Eternals, but amplified to a higher degree through a combination of his mutant Eternal heritage, bionic amplification, mysticism, and the power bestowed by abstract entity Death, demonstrating enormous superhuman strength, stamina, and durability. Thanos can absorb and project vast quantities of cosmic energy and is capable of telekinesis, telepathy, and matter manipulation. Thanos is an accomplished hand-to-hand combatant, having been trained in the art of war on Titan. Thanos has proved to be capable of briefly holding his own in a battle against Odin and blasting Galactus off his feet. Thanos is super genius in virtually all known fields of advanced science that created technology far exceeding contemporary Earth science. Remember that, because Dr. Manhattan is bound to Earth science, ain't he? Like, that's what he knows. He often employs a transportation chair capable of space flight, force field projection, teleportation, time travel, and the movement through alternate universes. Thanos is also a master strategist and uses several space vessels, at least three under the name Sanctuary, as a base of operations. One of the big weaknesses that I believe Dr. Manhattan has is he has a weakness against telepathy, I do believe. But I'm going to go over characters that I feel can defeat Dr. Manhattan, just to give you a gist on why I believe Thanos can defeat him. If any of you guys ever read the Preacher books, the Saint of Killers from the Preacher books, because he was empowered by God himself. He's impervious to harm. He took a direct hit by a nuclear weapon, no effect. Never misses a shot, and the shots are always fatal. He kills the devil with one shot. And if you haven't read it, stop right now, fast forward about 20 seconds, and then pick it back up. Because at the end of the series, he kills God. Now, I do believe that Manhattan could take out Saint. God couldn't do it, but I assume gods from different universes could have some effect. But if Saint has time to get a shot off before Dr. Manhattan makes him, then he could take down a big blue, which is, it's iffy. I'm trying to look for names you guys might know. I'm going through a list of just mutants and people that I got on here. I believe any like high level telepathics. Because he's never confronted by anybody, any enemy that could neutralize his strengths, which can include any type of psychic, any type of time manipulator, or any like powerful magic users or superior matter manipulators to him, or anybody who just warp reality, period. He's never faced anything like that. And Dr. Manhattan doesn't act like a hero to me neither. So I don't know. I think Thanos with a skill set. Let me check right quick. I gotta pull all this stuff up. I had it all written down. So we know what Thanos' powers are without the Infinity Gauntlet. What are Thanos' powers with the Infinity Gauntlet? Because in the picture that we're looking up there, he does have the Infinity Gauntlet. I really want to know what you guys think about this, like, for real. Because I think there's no way he can beat with telepathy and everything else. And that's just base Thanos. I think with Thanos, with Infinity, I think base Thanos can get him. But in the end, I don't think they try to fight. I think, like, Thanos will try to manipulate him. To be honest with you, manipulate him to work for him. Be my herald. Right? That's what I would do. What is going on? There's a lot of what-if comics for this freaking gauntlet, and I just want the whatchamacallit. Alright, when Thanos has the 6 Infinity Stones mounted, each gem grants the bearer complete mastery over one aspect of the multiverse. Time, space, mind, soul, reality, power. Combined with Infinity Gauntlet, Thanos is granted omnipresence, omniscience, and omnipotence. Now all powerful and desperate to win the effects of death, Thanos decides to offer the entity a gift of love by completing the task she had given him, erasing half the sentient life in the universe. He erased half the sentient life in the universe with a snap of his fingers. Bro, with a snap of his fingers, they didn't exist. Come on, man. He's going to be omnipresent, omniscient, and omnipotent, and has complete control, complete mastery over time, space, mind, soul, reality, and power. So his telepathy's just for the fact that he has the reality, the soul. We all know the friggin', regardless of what Dr. Man thinks, he's got a soul. He can be killed. He's a superpowered person. That's, you know what I'm saying, godlike powers. He's not even a celestial being. He's just really, really powerful. But for the fact that I do believe his mind could be affected with telepathy. You know what I'm saying? So I do believe the mind stone could warp his mind. The time stone and the space stone could keep, I believe those two in a combination could lock him in a moment and keep him from escaping. You know what I'm saying? With reality bending around him and he just be all powerful. It just makes no sense to me. But, I mean, y'all throw y'all arguments at the bottom for y'all think Dr. Manhattan could win, because I know a lot of people in the group believe that could happen. I stated this when I believe Dr. Manhattan has problems when Thanos doesn't have the Infinity Gauntlet. In the picture, he does. You're not beating Thanos with the Infinity Gauntlet. You know what I'm saying? It just makes no sense to me. But chime in, guys, in the bottom, and let us know what you think. All right, Thanos, souped up, omnipotent, omniscient, omnipotent Thanos, or you know what I'm saying, the blue naked dude running around in a world full of humans that thinks he's a god. All right, let me know what you guys think. And remember to come check us out over on Facebook. We always have chats and, you know what I'm saying, debates about like this if you guys are into this stuff. Sci-Fi-tology on Facebook, SYFYTOLOGY. You can also check it out, sci-fi-tology.com. Links to t-shirts, links to our podcast. We cover, we have Agents of Flashpoint, Gamer's Chair, the Beta Cast, and Whogasm. Cover Doctor Who, we cover Arrow, Flash, Legends, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., man, anything nerd life, we cover it. So come rock with us, and we hope to see y'all soon. Come over to the Facebook page, reduce yourselves, especially if you answer under this post. Come throw your two cents in over there, all right? Hope to see you guys too, and as always, for the order.